you have the left front on that line, bending left, and you move the hips away. So it's that idea that you should be able to have the front legs on the line and the hind legs you can move away, right? But see how he wanted to move the shoulders away too?
Yeah.
See, that's very common, right? The horses often can't separate the front and hind end enough. Like you ask them to move the hind end, but they move the shoulders too, away from your line. Maybe do it again because he's kind of...
He got better at it towards the end of it, but in the beginning of it he was
just drifting. Yeah, exactly. So of course, that's what they do in the regular lateral work too,
sure.
But you don't see it as easily if you don't have the poles down, right? The poles make it very, very clear when and where and how they cheat in a way, or you know, where they lose the coordination. To some extent, it's just a coordination issue. Just like riders have to learn to separate their muscles, right? So you engage your abs, but you don't clench your butt cheeks, that kind of thing. Mm-hmm. And so your hips and shoulders can work separately. It's the same for the horse. Good. And then... So again, into the corner, and the next time we say on this side of the poles, we'll ride a shoulder in.
Leg. Okay.
So which means now your right hind leg is on the line, you're moving the shoulders away to the left. So that's sort of the flip side of the coin, right? So the counter movement.
One here?
Yeah, but shoulder in left.
Over in left,
yeah.
So you want to sponsor.
Yeah, the right hand leg on the line, yeah, exactly.
So basically you're just doing the same thing, just on the other side of the
line. Yeah, if you didn't have the poles, it would look the same, but it's not the same in the sense that now you're moving the shoulders to the side, and the last exercise you move the hips away, right?
Gotcha.
So we'll do it again, maybe with a little less angle, actually.
Okay.
Look like we'll see. But see, this also forces the horse and the rider to think of lateral movements in the sense of where is the line, which leg is on the line, and which leg do I have to move away from the line. So now you bring the right hind leg on the line, and the shoulders go to the left. And you don't let the haunches go right. See how he stepped out with the right hind? That's the thing, right? You want to move the shoulders left, and he then will try to swing the haunches to the right, and it's not okay, right? We want the hind legs
so
exactly
right
on that line.
Catch that.
Right. So do it again, maybe again a little less angle, look like a four track. Just do it as a three track shoulder. And then you can compare. I mean, was the leg yield easier or was the shoulder in easier for the horse? For a lot of horses, the shoulder in is easier than the leg yield for some reason.
It seems with him like the leg yield is almost
easier. Yeah,
it more resistant.
Mm-hmm. Every horse is different.
Better.
Yeah, this is better there. Yeah. It's also because the angle is a little smaller.
Shallow.
Yeah, exactly. So that's more appropriate. And so that's good. So the next thing would be a haunches then.
Okay.
Which means now your right.
That's the one you like 2 weeks before.
Uh-huh, yeah. So the right front leg is on the line, you're on this side of the pole, and you move the hips away. And he has to bend in the direction of the movement, right? In the leg yield, he was kind of bending against the direction of the movement. Now it has to be bent in the direction. And see what issues come up, right? A lot of horses will back away from the line. He's not so bad. He stays pretty close. But the bend is sort of, you know, inconsistent, right?
Fluid.
It comes and goes a little bit.
Yeah,
good.
Not fluid, it's smooth.
Right. We'll do it again. And so he has a little time to get used to it, to that in his body.
More willing to try it today.
Yeah, exactly. That's good. So into the corner. And then here, same thing. The haunch is in. Right front leg on the line. Yeah. And the hips away. See, you can see how he struggles a little with that idea, you know, of separating the hips and the shoulders.
Yeah, kind of jiggles around a little bit.
Exactly. Yeah, the shoulders move a little bit, you know. And
yeah, he's trying to figure out what it is that I want. But he's just having difficulty maintaining it.
Right.
And it's that left rear, I think, that has such a hard time reaching, huh?
Yeah. Here in this punch is in, the left hand leg has to carry, right? So the right hand leg can cross over.
Mm-hmm.
But do it again. So think of bringing your outside hip back, inside hip forward. Going into it, it sometimes helps to lighten the seat for a couple of strides and then sit down on the inside hind leg. So shift your weight to the left. Left hind leg, there you go. And outside hip back, inside hip forward. You have to ride him forward from the inside leg, good. And then a little sideways from the outside leg. Good, better there. Do not better. So, Now you could do the same thing on the other side of the pole,
okay,
which technically makes it a revers. Right?
Okay.
Same thing. It's still everything else is exactly the same except that your poles are behind you now,
yeah.
And the left hind leg is on the line of the poles, and the shoulders are off to the right a little. But otherwise, it still feels like a haunches in leg. And you can compare this one, this revers version with the haunches in version, and see if there's a difference.
Sometimes I think it's metal for the rider.
Right, exactly.
Indeed.
In theory, it should be the same, but often this revers is harder. We'll do that again. He has a hard time bending there, doesn't he, in his
mm-hmm.
rib cage. He doesn't really want to give, so. And you can support him there in the bend by maybe stepping into the inside stirrup sometimes a little bit. Sometimes when the inside front is down, sometimes when the inside hind is down. And if he comes a little bit above the bit, step into the inside front, right? That helps you bring the head down again, and then it helps you lift the withers in the back, and you can bend a little bit the inside right at that moment. So now let's change direction, and then we'll go the other way. We'll basically do the same thing. First single track.
No, it's good. That's your point. You're fine.
Left bend is a little harder. Yeah. So first single track, just to show him the place again, the workspace, and gives him a little time to think. But, you know, it's not uncommon that you find that the simplest exercises are the most difficult to ride. Yeah.
Well, sometimes the slower the exercise, the harder it is to
exactly. There's an, I mean, when they go fast, they can cheat, you know.
Mm-hmm.
They can use
momentum behind them.
Yeah, they can use the speed to cheat and cover things up here. When you go slowly, you can really see what they're doing precisely. You know, you can see what's correct, what's not correct. So do the leg yield. So you go to the other side of the pole, and you move the hips away. Right front leg on the line, you bend right, and you let the haunches swing a little left. So that's fairly easy, it seems. Then he backs away a little, so you let the send him forward again. So they have to be balanced between both legs to be able to do these exercises. Uh-huh, exactly. And the poles show in how far that's successful, or the poles show you which leg needs to become more effective. But the leg yield is so good, so let's do the shoulder in. So you're on this side of the poles, my side of the poles. Oops, no, the other side.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So that's the leg yield again, right? Yeah. And then, good. Pretty good. Seems easier in this direction than in the other direction.
Well, I think because he's able to throw his haunch out, which is what he likes to do.
Yeah. Do the shoulder in again. Because of course he should not throw the haunches out in the shoulder in, right?
Mm-hmm.
And it didn't look like he was doing that, because otherwise he would have stepped on the pole.
True.
And so it's your job to control that outside hind with your outside seat-bone and your outside calf. So you sit on it a little bit and you have your outside leg back, so he can't swing out. This is pretty good. See, the bend is nice too.
Mm-hmm.
So it's easier for him somehow to do the shoulder in right than the shoulder in left. He's struggling a lot more with the shoulder in left. So now we'll do the haunches in. So you're on this side, right? Left front leg on the line, and the hips come away from the line. Bend him right.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise it would be counter shoulder in left. So bend right and hips away. And it's okay. I mean, if there is a problem with it, I want to see it, right?
Yeah.
It's because
he's peeking at something outside the door.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to get
that's what it was. Yeah.
Here.
Good. So do it again then. Because I want to see how easy or how hard it is physically, right? Mm-hmm. Like when he's not distracted. Okay, so there's a nice corner there. Bending right is hard, right? When you move the hips to the right. So haunches in general seems, including in part, both directions. And that's something that will interfere with your client's pain, but when he has a hard time with the haunches in.
He gets nervous about doing anything that makes him really challenge his haunch.
Right.
And once he gets nervous, then, starts
to have a little peace. Right. So it's good to teach him these things at the walk, where everything is slow and he has time to think. Where he can think where each foot needs to be and where his balance needs to be. In case, he's insecure about the balance. Sometimes that's kind of the problem, that they think they're going to fall over mm-hmm. if they bend in this direction or if they do a certain movement. Just do this as the raw bear version on the other side of the pole. Right? So everything is the same except you're on the other side now of the line. So the hips closer to the line, shoulders away. Sit on the right, left hip back, right hip forward, and bend hip right. And sit on the right, seat pole. Forward from the right leg, right? There you go. You can step into the right front sometimes.
That's taking it as the exact same thing.
Uh-huh. But it's different.
I
know, it's interesting, isn't it? There really should be no difference at all. I mean, it's the same movement. But just having the line of reference on the other side makes a difference for some reason. I'm still not really sure why. I don't know if it's all just psychological or...
Well, I think it's probably psychological with the rider as well. Mm-hmm, there's a guarantee that somehow the message I'm sending is not coming through as clearly as when there's a pole.
Yes,
the rider. What I'm trying to do with myself is have an imaginary pole.
Right.
Right where the other one would have been.
Right.
To try to help me attack that mental block that I must be sending to the door.
Right, exactly. Let's do one more. So hard for him, right? Bending to the right enough. He can do it as a shoulder lift. He has a hard time doing it as a long hand. So we'll practice that a little bit. So basically what I'm seeing here is that shoulder in long hand transitions around the ring would be really useful for him, right? Or just changing the bend in a lateral movement, haunches in, counter shoulder in, right? Leg yield half pass, and so on. We'll play with that a little bit. So bend in the right. You have to frame that right shoulder a little with the right knee and right, and then flex right. Good, like that. So let's go away from the whole thing. Maybe trot. We'll go whole school so he can think about this for a second. We'll take the pressure off and see how the trot feels after all this. So often they feel much better, even though they exercise.
Thank you.
something to be upset about.
So Reese was saying to him that she's driving, working, she's driving on down. I'm sure that he's thinking about that. So he has to go to the way that was wrong by then. It's the density of the transition between the two. You have the arms that come off the wall, but you need to be there. Keep the arms out and then, and then face the same, so in again.
Yeah, he wants to come back to the list.
Right, exactly. Okay, right. So they can write it because he's the call. And he's the call and face the same, that's the least side. And push the arms out all the way.
Thank you. That's what I'm thinking. Say that that is definitely true of him. Left is his challenge.
I showing, they're reminding what to do, they're walking,
like it had some better moments.